To begin operating the ellipsometer, you need to select the SAM icon on the desktop. This opens the system operation software, and a startup process will proceed with lights flashing in the top right-hand corner. When the startup process is complete, a green light in the corner will show. To log in, click on Login and select User as the username. No password is required. If the light source has not already been switched on, this can be done so by selecting the system icon along the bottom, then selecting light source, and then switching on. In this menu, you can see the status of the light source. Once a light source has been switched on, wait at least 15 minutes for it to warm up and stabilize before operation. The first step of sample measurement is the focusing of the instrument. This focus procedure allows the system to identify the optimum Z-axis height to ensure maximum intensity of the beam reaching the detector. To set up the focus, select Manual along the bottom and click on RC Focus by Signal. Firstly, the user will need to know the approximate thickness of their substrate and sample to allow the instrument to accurately measure the exact Z point. This can be input in sample thickness and then select Go to Prefocus. When this is clicked, you will see the stage move upwards to a predetermined point. Next, select the incident angle at which you'll be making your measurement, the number of measurement counts to find the focus, and the step size in microns. Increasing the measurement count and the step size will allow greater chance of finding the focus point. To start the focus, click on Start. The instrument will now measure light intensity hitting the detector as a function of the Z position of the stage. If the intensity maximum is reached, the instrument will automatically identify this point and save the correct coordinates without any further input from the user. If no maximum has been reached, the user can go back into focus settings and change either the sample thickness, the manual stage coordinate, or either measurement counts or step size. To make a measurement, select RC ellipsometry measurement. Here the user can select multiple angles by hitting Add and changing the step size. Background measurements can be made, which uses the detector to determine what background light is reaching there without any light source. You can change the detector settings by selecting either R, VIS, and NIR, or both. Greater integration time will allow for a cleaner signal, but longer measurement time. And also mirror correction can be used for glass samples. To start a measurement, click on Start Measurement. When the measurement is finished, you can see the raw data results in the tabs along the top. You have options of psi delta, tan psi cos delta, alpha beta, rho. And you can save measurement by clicking on Save Measurement. For ellipsometric porous symmetry measurements, it's recommended that the user heat the sample to above 100 degrees for several minutes to ensure that there's no adsorbed water on the surface of the sample. The instrument needs to be focused as described before. And then when focused, select the EPA menu from the manual tab. There are two menus for the EPA measurement. Firstly, the SE settings are exactly as described before. You need to change the incidence angle, background correction, mirror correction, and your detector settings and integration time. Additionally, under porous symmetry settings, you need to select the number of steps required and the time for each step corresponding to a relative humidity value. Be sure to set the 0% relative humidity value to 180 seconds to allow the system to equilibrate, and select RH increments, keeping in mind the trade-off between number of data points and length of measurement time. The point at which capillary condensation occurs depends on the pore size, so there may be some trial and error involved, but generally it is recommended to increase the number of points at higher relative humidity values. When finished setting up of the parameters, the user can save by clicking Export and saving your sequence. This same sequence can be imported into the desorption cycle by clicking on Import, selecting the sequence, and then clicking Reverse. Before running the measurement, untick Constrain on both sides. Then click Start Measurement. In the measurement results menu, you can monitor the current status of relative humidity for each step. And then the instrument goes through each relative humidity step, providing ellipsometric spectra for each one. Once all measurements are made, you can proceed to the analysis step.